हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज हर्माफ्रोडिटिज्म। हर्माफ्रोडिटिज्म व्हाट इज दिस? दैट हर्माफ्रोडिटिज्म लिटरली मीन्स दैट द वन पर्सन हैविंग बोथ सेक्स, दैट इज अ फीमेल एंड मेल, इट नेचुरली हैपेंस इन सम ऑफ द स्पीशीज, सम वॉर्म्स एंड फिशेस। दिस इज द क्राइटेरिया दैट हर्माफ्रोडिटिज्म मीन्स one person having both sex. On one side it should be a testis and other side it should be ovary. So this is a typical example of hermaphroditism. So hermaphroditism can be two. It can be pseudo or it can be true. What is true hermaphroditism? True hermaphroditism means both sex are present in one person. And when I talk about sex, I talk about the gonads. The testis and ovaries both should be present in a one person. That is true hermaphroditism. Now, what is pseudo hermaphroditism? Pseudo hermaphroditism means there are actually no both gonads available. For example, there is no ovary and testis both available in the person. There is either ovary or either testis. But again, the person looks like the female or male and not according to the genitalia in that or the gonads in that. That means pseudo hermaphroditism means genotype is not equal to phenotype. Means some person is genotypically male. Genotypically, if you do a karyotype, their genes will be XY. That ideally should be a male. But the genitalia of and the phenotype of that person look like a female. So it is called pseudo-hermaphroditism. But it is called male pseudo-hermaphroditism. Means that is a if it is a female. If it is a male pseudo-hermaphroditism, that means the genetics will be XY. Genetically, the person is male, but it looks like a female genitalia. So it is a male pseudo-hermaphroditism. What is female pseudo-hermaphroditism? In which the genes are XX of female, but the genitalia looks like male. So it is a female pseudo-hermaphroditism. Thank you.